What's up, RPG fans, and welcome to Retro Plastic Gaming Live of The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. Last time, we did the Snow Temple. So, what I did off-camera, guys, what you guys didn't see me do, is I went back, reverted time, defeated the boss again, collected 100 rupees, did the inverted song of time, and made time slow, so we're back on the first day, but I did go back to where we saved, so we had a little bit of consistency. So right now we're actually gonna go and get the second bottle and do the Goron race, and we're also gonna get an upgraded sword. So first we need to go to Mountain Village. So we give him 100 rupees, and pretty much what we do is we go ahead and leave and go ahead and do the Goron race. So let's go ahead and put on the bunny hood and go and do that. Let's see here, I get a little turned around. Let's go and see what the sign says. Pretty sure that's the way to snow it. Yeah, it is. So that's our any of the comments during the stream, so I do apologize for lack of interaction between me and you. But this game is a little difficult, so it's nothing personal. I'm just more or less trying to get through the game as quickly as possible for you guys. Now, going through this area right here, of course you could go through here wearing the Goron mask, but again, the Gorons cannot swim. So just in case you might get knocked over, it's best if you run through here wearing bunny hood. Technically speaking, while the snow was actually everywhere, it was actually safer for Gorons to travel through there, but now that because they can't swim, it's a little harder. Now, the whole reason that we're going up in here is actually for storyline purposes, to talk with the chief and everybody. And how sad is that? They don't even realize that their friend is not actually alive, but dead. The greatest of Gorons! The greatest of Gorons! These guys are dorks. So the next thing we need to go and do, so now that we did that, is actually go and get Powder Cake certified. And to go and do that is actually really easy. So once we leave, we're gonna go ahead and go around the corner. And the Powder Cake's actually over this way. So right here, instead of trying to get to the Goron races and end up having to turn back around, we just go ahead and just come here first. You can, technically speaking, go to the Goron races beforehand, but you'd just be wasting your time. Now with the Powder Cake, you do have plenty of time to carry it there, just don't dilly-daddle. Now most Powder Cakes actually do not have that long of a fuse, so it's special. Get over to where the wolves are. I recommend to just run around them if you can. I do not heavily stress hard enough to be extremely careful in this spot. Gorons cannot swim. Oh. probably have to go and get another one. We're almost done with this task, too. I do apologize for the mistake right there. Could actually get over there to me like that. Failed? In that case, I can't preview the used powder case. Do you want to take the challenge again? Why, yes, sir, Rebob, I sure do. Also, folks, if you don't mind giving this a like and a share, we must appreciate it. Remember, though, folks, when you go ahead and share this, be sure to change your settings when you share from private to public if you guys don't mind. If that doesn't go against your own standards, because in order to be Facebook's algorithm, that's what you gotta do. I do apologize if the music's a little loud. I did turn it down a little bit, but if I turn it down anymore, there are super quiet parts to this game, and that would take away your experience. Again, folks, try and be careful through this spot. Gorons cannot swim. I want to stress that this may take me a few tries. The Goron race is not easy, but we have to do it in order to upgrade our sword and get the next bottle. Thank you. Front of me. That sucked. Well, it's a good thing we got plenty of time. I'm busy, so don't bother. Check that shit out. He's working on her sword. Actually, he's not actually doing anything. He's just being lazy. Alright, so let's go ahead and play this song a double time and get on to the next day. So a song a double time is... So let's make it tomorrow morning. Inside and bother them again, and then come back out. It's super weird not having her sword. Alright, let's go ahead and play a song in double time again. Second day. 48 hours remain. Okay, let's go ahead and turn around. I kept you waiting, but it's done. See? Check that shit out. What an awesome sword. Too bad it's going to be really short-lived for how long that we actually have it. And pretty much it's a dollar a swipe. Because you paid 100 rupees and you only get to slash it 100 times. But guess what? We're not gonna actually hold onto the sword very long, so we're gonna just go ahead and get rid of it right now. We're gonna go ahead and pull it out so you guys can check it out real quick. Check that out. Well, there it goes. Customer. All right, so let's go ahead and bring out the gold dust. Why isn't that gold dust? And it's even top quality. Why, even if I use to reforge your sword, there'll be still some left. ... Alright, just for you, I'll do this for free, but don't tell anyone. Thanks for dropping in. Now I'm straight off to work. Come back tomorrow morning. Alright, let's play the song at double time again. Time. Go ahead and turn around and go up in here. And let's go ahead and get our new sword. Alright, we got the the Gilded Sword, check out that badass sword that we now have. One thing I forgot to go and do is we need to go back to the Goron village and go get our certification. So let's go ahead and go do that. And then we're gonna go ahead and warp to the first day. Now the next things that we got to do before we go even to the next place is we need to go to Romani Ranch and do some of that stuff as well. Because now is the time to do it. We'll be getting our third bottle over there, so that's why it's part of the process. And it's important to actually have these mini bottles before we go to the ocean because of some of the storyline things that we have to do there. Alright, we got a powder keg. Unfortunately, though, when we go back in time, it goes away. But the powder keg certification thing doesn't go away, at least. So we'll have to buy one to go into Germani Ranch. That's okay. Alright, let's go ahead and play the song of time. Folks, I am well aware I'm losing 23 rupees. It's not that big of a deal. Dawn of the first day. And always, folks, one thing you need to do right off the bat every single time you play the Song of Time is, oh yeah, and one thing that was done off of camera and I little regret it is your fairy doesn't say to the ocean, etc. Like, she says a little thing about going to the ocean palace, but unfortunately, because I did stuff off of camera, such as doing the boss battle again, it's not going to be said. That's my only thing I regret. But anyways, every single time you go back in time, always play the inverted Song of Time, just so that time slows down and you do not run out of time. Okay, so since we did that, let's go ahead and collect our 100 rupees. Once we collect these 100 rupees, we're going to go ahead and go to the bomb shop. There's a Goron there, but he only sells powder cakes to Gorons, so we're going to have to go ahead and put on the Goron mask for that. Now this chest is here every time you go back in time, so always be sure to go and get it. Alrighty then, so the Goron shop is actually over this way. Thank you. The Goron is chilling inside of the shop. Let's see here. First door right here, I believe. Yeah, he's right here. And ironically, the powder cakes here are 40 rupees versus, well, 50, excuse me, versus, like, more than that in the Goron Village, which makes no sense. Alrighty, so before we couldn't get to Germani Ranch because of the big giant boulder, but guess what? Now we have a way to get there. So I believe that would be Milk Road. Explosivo thing, probably get some arrows, etc. on our way over there. By the way, check out that awesome gilded sword, folks. Look how huge that sword is. It's literally longer than my body. Bunny hood. Let's go ahead and go over this way now, over to their house. Look, there's Ifona. This part's a little weird. Yeah. Alright, so she's gonna have us ride our own horse to do this. Now, folks, I hope you guys do all remember this is part of the storyline. You have to do this, these things before you go to the next place. Stream Mask. The previous episodes are uploaded on YouTube. If you guys are enjoying this Let's Play, be sure to go ahead on over there and leave a thumbs up on those real super quick. That shows a lot of appreciation for all of this hard work that we do here. If you guys were wondering how to get to our YouTube, the link is actually in the description of the video as well. Alrighty then, so the girl's gonna actually have us wait here. Okay, so let's go ahead and use the ocarina to do the song in double time. Night of the First Day. Alright, so let's go ahead and go inside for a little bit of talking. I have no idea why they were starting to glitch like that. So let's go ahead and speak. Alrighty then, so let's go ahead and go outside and actually get a little more acquainted with Ifona, because I've not ridden her very much. Now the ghost won't be showing up until 2 in the morning. I'm gonna go ahead and play the inverted song and see if the revert time back to normal. Now that time's back to normal, we won't take us very long to fix things. So let's go ahead and just ride around on our horse and collect a few things, such as like what's in here. And an odd thing I wanted to point out is the only difference between the large quiver and the quiver we have right now currently is 10 arrows. So I'm not overly worried about it. Just trying to get a little more acquainted with the Romani Ranch, so that when the aliens come at 2 in the morning, we're not caught off guard. So the part of the reason why, folks, it's so important to get to do these things before you go to the next ocean, go to the ocean place, is actually because you need more than just 2 bottles to collect to finish that. By doing this, we'll be getting the 3rd bottle. So as soon as we get the next bottle, we're going to go ahead and then be slowing the flow of time down. So, I believe you need to have at least 4 bottles before you do the next area, and the reason why is because you have to put Zora eggs inside of them, if I remember correctly. All right, it's already 9 p.m. at night, and she said that she's going to have a show up be around here at 2 in the morning. Thing I'd like to point out right here, if it lets us actually do it, let's go ahead and get down. Look at that moon. Just look at it. Look at it. Now, in this game, there are 4 temples and 1 giant moon that kind of just, as you can see there, hangs over Termina, right? Okay, so to tell everybody that what I'm getting to is, the moon represents depression, and the 4 temples represent the other things of suffering, which is, you know, well, death, accepting of death. It's denial, acceptance, depression, bartering, and I always forget a couple of them. But that's essentially, it's pretty much what this game is talking about, in every sense of it. That's what's going on with those things, folks. All right, it's almost time. Again, the moon represents depression ever hanging there, and the 4 temples represent the other areas of accepting about the stages of death. The guy who created this game, little fun fact, is he personally did that on purpose, and it was due to the fact of how much time he actually had to make this game. So the one thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be trying to keep the aliens, per se, from stealing cows. Although I thought this was really strange that they had put this there. All right, here she comes. Here they come. Thank you. Oh, looks like we're gonna fail this. Yep, we sure fucking did. That sucks, but at least you guys get to see what happened. Definitely try again. It's not very hard of a thing to do. I just messed up. So let's go ahead and warp back to Clock Town then. Deposit these 59 rupees. Sucks I messed up on doing that the first time, but there's actually two things that you have to do back to back correctly, and that's doing the alien thing and helping out her older sister when she goes to leave to keep the some Guerrero brothers, I think they're Argaro brothers or something like that, from stealing her milk. She's gonna deliver the cart to the town. So let's go ahead and collect the 100 rupees that are over here. This time I'm not gonna play the inverted song of time because we have time. And we don't wanna wait. I don't wanna make you guys wait around too much. Folks, just remember to always put on your Goron mask when you go to talk to this Goron to buy, because he will not sell it to you if you are a Link, because he only sells the Gorons. So let's go ahead and go outside, and the first thing we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to collect a few things. Mm-hmm. good times, right? Do the Fona thing again. It doesn't work like that. Check that shit out. The dog's afraid of me. Do it like this again in order for her to be okay with us helping her. And I'll be a lot more careful with the arrows this time. I think the way I used to always do it is I would just walk, run around, and then hit them. Alright, let's go ahead and do her little test thing again. Actually, I think it's a bad idea to actually be on the horse. It also bugs me that the fact that they don't give you unlimited arrows too while you're on the horse is like, do that while I'm practicing, but. So I think my strategy is going to be is I'm just going to run around this freaking barn off the horse, as I feel like that probably would work a lot better. And I'm not going to cut those down in order to keep the... Oh, let's go ahead and talk to this. We haven't done that yet. Let's go ahead and put on the Mask of Truth on. The mystical stone responds to the mask and speaks to you, but its words are heard in secret. It seems that Kefe, whose whereabouts are unknown, are awaiting a letter from Aju. That makes no sense, but okay. I'm gonna go ahead and ride on my horse, just to chill out. I'll come read your comments in just a second, folks. While I'm waiting for time to go by. It's already 7. Alright, let me go ahead and park my ass right here. I'm gonna go and read your comments real fast. Thanks, you guys, for joining us here. I just went through our comments really fast. Alright, it looks like we're closely approaching the appointed time. So it's now 10 p.m. and we have to wait till 2 a.m. It's now 11 p.m. and we're waiting for 2 a.m., folks. Hey, I'm gonna go ahead and get off the horse. And honestly, it's going to be a lot easier to do things like this than riding on a horse. Nice range on that. Oop, getting in close to the appointed time. I call that Link Aerobics. Oh, here she comes. Hopefully we don't mess up a second time. Here they come. Tell you guys, it's the best way to do it. Stay off the fucking horse. Yeehaw. Got a mountain bottle, one quick gulp, and you'll have a you will have you feeling great. You see to take a drink. Alrighty then, so we're gonna go ahead and wait. I think we'll go inside first. Ranch opens at 6 a.m. Let's go ahead and pause this. Let me see what we're supposed to do next. I know we're supposed to help her deliver the bottles into town. Let me see how we're supposed to go about that. Okay, so let's go ahead and wait till we hit 6 a.m. when the ranch opens. There we go. Bell rings. About to do it. About to do it. So let's go ahead and go in. So we're gonna go ahead and now go outside, play the song a double time. There she is. Oh, good evening. Look at that. Talk about a total game glitch right there. About sometimes it can get worse and larger in your face. Actually, I thought this was a lot easier than the other ones. I just kinda... Yeah. I thought it was a little strange that you're hitting with an arrow and it doesn't kill. Seriously, I'm fucking hitting them with arrows. Awesome, we got the Romani Man. I'm going to go ahead and pause this so I can see what we're supposed to be doing next. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to get the stone mask. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and go to town and deposit those 100 rupees. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna want to go and do is, like always, we're gonna go ahead and play the inverted song of time. Okay, and let's go ahead and equip the bunny hood. Go and get those 100 rupees. The next thing we're going to be doing is the graveyard, which is where we'll be getting the next bottle, which in turn would be our fourth one, which is how many is required to do the next area. Before we go to the graveyard. Okay then, let's go ahead and go outside. And before we go ahead and be heading on over to the graveyard, let's go ahead and collect. Second, let me check my thing right here. There's a whole process to this madness, I promise. Thank you. So here we're going to be getting the captain's hat. Let's go ahead and equip this. Looks like we already did most of what we're supposed to be doing here, so let's go ahead and restart time again. Let me go ahead and deposit those rupees. Try this again. Yeah, sometimes on some of these little smaller tasks, you can mess up. Go ahead and play the inverted song of time. Let's go ahead and collect our 100 rupees, and then we'll go outside wearing the Goron mask. Put that on now. Replace the arrow, our bow and arrow, with the ocarina. And there's Ifona. As long as you're wearing the stone mask, those little bastards from Mario 64 won't bother you. This may take you a couple of tries, just like it's doing me a couple of tries. Go ahead and deposit the rupees and reset time. Unfortunately, that's just the way the cookie crumbles. works out in our favor slightly, because we do have to have a certain amount of rupees by the end of the game. Alrighty then, so let's go ahead and play the inverted song of time. Which is actually a hidden song, by the way. This is not a song that you are taught, and it is not also here either, see? This was the one missing song we have, which is the song... Song of Storms, by the way. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and skip getting the 100 rupees. We're just gonna go outside. See if we can do this. Got the captain's hat. And how many masks does that make so far that we've earned that are non-magic? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So no, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 masks that we don't have. All right, so let's go ahead and put on the captain's hat. Here's something that's kind of funny. Let's go ahead and put it on. Kind of scares the crap out of him, but it's funny. Look at that, he's just running away. So first thing we're gonna go ahead and do is go over to this grave.
Ha ha ha!
Like a bunch of hearts there. The Mario. Alrighty then, out we go. That lousy bastard only left us a bomb. Cheap scum. Severely important to collect heart pieces in this game. We wouldn't have as many heart containers as we did if we didn't. Supposed to play the song a double time. Just let me read this real fast and I'll tell you right now. Yeah, we're supposed to play the song a double time. Second grave is going to be a heart piece, and that'll be our second to a full heart container. You're not supposed to go anywhere, but instead if you just walk through there, there you go. You could also use the lens of truth. And here you are going to be wanting to use it though, as there are hidden enemies. Sense, did it, folks?
Ha!
Okay, I'm just gonna go with it and just go along the lines of, you can't jump in this. Honestly, going out of this place is actually harder than going in, though. So that would have technically been our 20th heart piece, but because we're behind on those, that is actually technically number 17 for us. Actually, that would have been number 21. So that's actually the duck 3 is number 18. I mean, number 18 for us. If you've been following along with my Let's Play, at this point of the game, you should have 4 bottles after we do this last task. Yeah. So in here is actually a bit of a mini game. Kind of fun. Kind of pain in the ass though. Oh yeah, and you're gonna want to go to the wall. Wall master. The best way to do this, folks, is to use the Z targeting and lead him where you want him to go. Looks like they're gonna make things really difficult for us. Now they do make the algorithm for this different every single time. So the holes may differ from when you play it than when I'm doing.
Whee!
This part of the game is rather irritating and annoying. It's a necessary demon. And much like last time, you have to be a little kind of bit in a hurry so you get up top. Otherwise, you'll miss him. And you have to be careful, kind of lure him away from the edge, because he will just fall off. So just take your time right here. Thing that we got to do after we collect this bottle here is we're going to go ahead and you take the spirit of the Poe and you sell it at the curious shop and you get a shit ton of money. And we have the fourth bottle now. Let me show you guys that I do have them. So there's actually two more bottles after that. Go ahead and equip one, and let's go ahead and put the spirit of the Poe in the ball. Look at that, look at this guy. He's underneath his bed hiding. And what gets me is he has a direct connection with the place underneath. That's just strange. All right, let's go ahead and go to Clock Town. Such a waste to take the big Poe and collect money for it other than to empty our wallets. Alright, next place we're gonna go is the curiosity shop. That's actually right here. Opens at 10 p.m. We came an hour too early. How funny. Just waiting for the curiosity shop to open, folks. So far, I just want to do a recap of what we do have. Here's our inventory. We have 4 bottles. There are 9 masks that we do not have. 1 transformation mask that we do not have, which is the Zora mask. And then this mask right here is a special mask. That is the deity mask. Or transforms you into Adult Link. And then we're missing 2 of the spirit masks that are here, which are those, which are different. Those are from the each temples. We now have each of those songs, and we are missing 2 of the songs that warp us, but actually not warp us, but do different things for us. And I believe we're missing, which ones are we missing? The Elegy of Emptiness and the New Wave Bossa Nova. Those are the 2 songs that we're missing. Oh, 10 o'clock. Let's go ahead and go in. Talk about a really shitty Alright folks, I'm not going to be doing it today, that'll be tomorrow. Tomorrow's broadcast of this game, we're going to be doing the the Great Bay Coast, the Zora's Mask, Using the Mask, the Statue and Map, and to the Fortress. And then we'll be doing whatever things that we need to do over there. Let's go ahead and restart time. Like always, whenever you reset time, the first thing you want to do right off the bat is play the inverted song of time. Save yourself a lot of heartache. Go ahead and go to this over to this owl statue. All right, folks, thank you for joining us here at Retro Plastic Gaming Live for our live Let's Play of the Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. I'm Chris. And here's our slogan. I'll see you all in the next level, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm sorry I didn't do Disney Wednesday today. I was running a little behind, but I didn't want you guys to be without more Majora's Mask. So we'll be back tomorrow. We'll be doing a much longer stream of that because that area takes much longer. We may even have to split that area into two parts, which I don't like to do, but we'll see what happens. All right, folks. See you all in the next level.